tout le monde. Good morning, everybody. I'm here to talk to you about this new paper that we did in PNAS recently about the activation of sympathetic nervous system mediates hypophagic and anxiety-like effects of CB1 receptor blockade. Normally, when we have to present our results to people, one has to think what is the key message of a paper. And yesterday evening I was thinking about this, and actually this paper was started on an intense work made by my former PhD student and postdoc Luigi Bellocchio on the role of CB1 receptor on food intake. Actually, however, I think that the most interesting and intriguing message of the paper is the final experiment of the paper, in which we show basically a principle that is quite interesting and I didn't think about before, that is related to fear and anxiety. Actually, we know that when we are afraid, when we are scared or anxious, we have several autonomous peripheral effects. We start to sweat, our heart beating is increased, and so on and so on. And this is a response to the fear. However, there could be also the inverse relationship. If our heart starts to beat faster, and if we start to sweating and we don't know the reason, this is generating fear. So, what we show in this paper is that actually the sympathetic peripheral nervous system is a kind of funneling mechanism through which CB1 blockade, the administration of CB1 antagonist, modulate both the decrease of food intake but also central and peripheral effects of on anxiety and fear. Indeed, what we showed, just to make the story short, we showed that if we delete CB1 from many different neuronal populations in the brain, we do not change the effect of rimonabant, of a CB1 antagonist, on food intake. However, we block completely this effect if we block peripheral sympathetic transmission. Interestingly, as I said before, we can block by sympathetic peripheral blockade also central and peripheral effects of rimonabant on anxiety and fear. So this is, in conclusion, is a nice and intriguing, and for sure we need still to work a lot to understand all the mechanism, but this study tells us that independently where the main effect of a drug could be, there could be also peripheral funneling expression of effects that are mediating the pharmacological effect that we can observe. Finally, I would like to thank all the people that participated to this work, in particular Luigi Bellocchio and Edgar Soria, and Daniela Cota here in Bordeaux, and Manuel Gutzmann in Madrid. Thank you very much for your attention.